the boards. Dupuy into the middle. Redden held the puck in. Knocked out of the air by Crosby. Gains center ice. Hits the empty net. And that should do it. With 8 seconds to go, Sidney Crosby seals the deal. Pittsburgh 3, Ottawa 1.
Well, it's the way this series pretty well has gone, where every time Ottawa seems to try to grab momentum, and that Vermette goal that was disallowed, the disallowed goal by Vermette, really has been a tough thing to overcome for the Senators as the puck follows up the boards and a little turnover at the blue line. No chance. You're trying to get it to the net. It goes to the one guy you don't want it to, which is Sidney Crosby. And he makes no mistake putting this in and sealing the deal for the Pittsburgh Penguins as they will go on and sweep the Ottawa Senators here at Scotiabank Place.
Well, we've witnessed the start of what might be something very special, Gary. This team could be good for a while, but they are, in my estimation, a cup contender this year. They've got a ways to go, but if we've seen in this series, while they haven't had the resistance they might get in some, that they're an extremely talented team that could go a long ways. Series is over. Pittsburgh has the sweep, and for Ottawa, the soul-searching and the question-asking can begin for Wade Redden. After almost 950 games in a Senator uniform, this might be it.
Look at Mr. Redden looking on as the Pittsburgh Penguins celebrate and a well-deserved series win for the Pittsburgh Penguins. I don't think anybody that witnessed this series could say that they didn't deserve to be right where they are right now. They did a fabulous job, and the coaching staff right on through. And they will get to do right now what was done to them last year. As this year, though, they'll have bigger smiles on their face, and they'll look at this as a building block, as they haven't had a lot of adversity in this series. They will certainly face more as they move along, but they'll have a series win under their belt to take with them, Jim.
This series has been a little bit about how good Pittsburgh is. It's been a lot about how far Ottawa has fallen since Christmas time and since the end of the playoffs last season, where we thought, now there's the adversity. They lost to Anaheim, but this year they might go all the way. These teams will meet again in Stockholm in late September, early October. One of them might have a cup. The other one, I suspect, will look a little different.
Well, there's no doubt that the Ottawa Senators and the general manager, Brian Murray, will have to take a look at what happened down the back half of this season and in this playoff series and evaluate his team and his players, and there will be changes. There always are. You look at last year's team, there was changes from that team that went to the cup final. There'll certainly be changes from this year, and some familiar faces that fans are used to seeing here will no longer be, as the Senators will certainly try to rebuild and get to where they were.
So a disappointing end to a season during which they just couldn't stop the slide that started at about New Year's. And for the Pittsburgh Penguins, it's on to round number two, led by a young goaltender and some great young forwards. And a veteran now in Marian Hossa, who gets to join this talented crew. We'll remind our listeners that soon we're headed for Nashville against Detroit, but right now it's time to meet Scott and Sid.
All right, Jim, thanks very much. Penguins sweep an opening round series for the first time since 1989, when they dispatched the Rangers, and Sidney Crosby was heading for his second birthday. Sidney, a lot of people are going to talk about the poise and maturity of the young Penguins after this win. Do those two words apply?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, we knew they were going to be desperate here tonight, and we sat back a little bit in the third. We didn't get a lot of shots, but we played strong defensively, and guys were willing to do whatever it took to get the win here.
A lot of people think this will be the start of something special. Do you think the Penguins have it in them to do what the Senators did a year ago? That's build off a quick first round and go all the way to the Stanley Cup final?
Yeah, I hope so. I mean, you know, to go through the first round in four games, I think, gives you a little bit of a rest, and we're not too banged up, so that's going to help, but it doesn't get any easier from here, and we'll know next opponent's going to be just as tough, if not tougher.
Sidney, I don't think a lot of people are surprised that the Penguins managed 16 goals in four games in this series, but are you surprised you're able to keep the Senators to five?
Yeah, big time. I mean, they have a lot of weapons, and Mark was big, our D played great, and we got some bounces, but you know, our role players were the ones who stepped up big. I mean, third, fourth line, those guys got some huge goals for us, and they were the difference.
If I had told you before this series you could sweep the Senators, would you believe me?
No, definitely not. But, you know, we took it a game at a time, and we found ourselves in good position here today. We want to finish it off, so definitely feels good.
Sidney, thanks for your time. Congratulations on an outstanding performance.
Thank you.
Ron, back to you.